So this is cutting in two boxes. One has two swing pole switches, and one has a three-way switch. The other one has a three-way switch and one single pole. Identify all the switch legs and the three wires. They're going to make it travel to the next switch where it's switched in different locations. First, I'll strip all the wires. Okay, in this box, you're going to pay attention to your travelers that are going to go to the other switch for a three-way circuit. You're going to pay attention to your two single pole switch legs. In this particular application, the switch leg for this three-way switch is on the other end, so all I've got to feed this one. I'll get to that. First step is to isolate all your ground wires. Normally, it can be about 6 inches outside of the box. I'll leave one long pigtail, roughly 18 inches or so, or 20 inches, so that when I install my switches, I can wrap the ground screw around the ground of the switch. Packed back in the back, leaving the ground wire hanging out. You want it accessible when you go to finish packing everything back. Second thing, you want to get your neutrals together. All the neutrals. New code states that all switches have to have a ground neutral in each box. But they don't get a pigtail, so I'm just gonna strip the wires and put them under a wire nut. I don't really twist these, I just lightly squeeze them as I go around to let them form a coil, but you don't want to twist really hard to break the copper and it won't be connected. Even though it looks like it's connected, sometimes they'll break and you'll lose a light. And you don't know why, but a lot of times it's in this junction right there that you lose a neutral and the light won't work. So I have 2 feeds in this box. use some excess switch leg and travelers to make three pigtails, 3 feet, 1 foot switch. And this is a 3-gang switch. By code, you can put 6 wires under a wire nut, and I'm only putting 5, so I'm good. Cut them off clean and give them an extra little twist on the edge so they'll fit into your wire nut and you gotta screw it on. Okay, folding this back, we're gonna use each one of these 3 wires for a switch. And my travelers will get a switch, a pigtail. For a hot. So I'm feeding it over here and I'm hanging it over there. That's terminology meaning the switch is being fed here. The switch leg is the common on the other side where it's being switched. So I identify it. I wrap it around like that so I know that the wire that's coiled is my common. But I also we'll strip the end of that one just so it's identifiable when I go to put my device on, my switch. These other two, I just twist. I leave about 3 inches straight. But when I pack it back, I'm going to pull it out and put my devices on after the sheetrock's been applied. I have plenty to work with when I go to put my device on. So right here I will have two single poles and one three-way. Over here I've determined that this is my 3 wire for my travelers. This is a switch leg for a fan and a light, which is also a 3-way, 3 wire. And I have 2 feeds. Strip my wires. Some people use razor knife. I don't like razor knives. So I use Remex strippers. Which switch is going to be first. So in this wire is controlling the fan and the fan light. The black will be used for the fan. I'll make that my second switch. The fan light is usually used the red. And I'll make that my first switch. That's the first switch you want to hit is a light switch when you're coming in. I isolate all my grounds. this one I'm going to leave two pigtails for the grounds. The reason I left the long one here is because I didn't want to overload my wire nut with more than six wires under it. Again, I'll use a little, just a little squeeze when I twist so it'll curl the wires without actually twisting it.
If you come a little closer, you can see what I mean. And then I'll cut the ends off flat and I'll do a little twist on the end, not really grabbing the wire, but just letting the side cutters roll around it so that they'll form a good end that the wire nut will grab onto pretty easy and keep the wires tight. One will go to one switch, one will go to the other switch. It doesn't really matter how you pack those back. Then you grab your neutrals. Which is all the white wires. Kind of form them back where you can pack them back really neat. I use about that rule of thumb, just my fingers and a little bit of my thumb to gauge how long I want to keep it in the box. Little squeeze and a little twist, a little squeeze and a little twist. You don't want to grab it and like torque it down really tight because you can break that wire easily. It's very delicate. Twist them clockwise so your wire nut, this wire nut's not grabbing right. So grabbing another one. Sometimes they're not. The spring that's inside of them doesn't quite do right, and you can feel it. It won't tighten up. You want one that's going to tighten to almost a stop to where you feel a really good tight fit. Okay, so we have two pots that are coming in this box. We're going to pigtail these. Cut me some out of some scrap wire that I had left over from pulling wire earlier. I'm really going to use the blacks out of this. We want a good 12 inches or so, 6 inches at the end of it, but you want to make sure you leave yourself enough to work with when you're installing your switch. Okay, so here I have put too many pigtails because I remember that this switch is being fed here and switch legged over there. So I don't need but one of these. So I took one off. I'm just gonna have to torque down the wire nut a little bit tighter to make sure it's secure. So we have travelers here And this is, these go with the light switch. And then you have your two wires, which is one of the blacks that you pigtailed, and the switch leg for the fan. And twist these together so I know those go on one switch. And the common is the switch leg here, which I'll do a spiral twist to let myself know that this was my common on my switch when I go to put the switches on later on. Cut them about the same length. Strip my common so I identify it a little bit better in case it gets messed with the sheetrock guys. Pack everything back. And you're ready for sheetrock. Thanks for watching.